Now we are. Well, give me a second. It's been taking a minute to, like, do live on. That's so weird. Now we are. I need some sun. It says super tall giraffe girl. She's number one.
Super tall giraffe girl's number one?
Yeah. Sup, JJ? Roxy, Sandy, Justine, Fluid Art. So, I think I'm gonna do some gold today. It's cute. It's so funny, I'm looking at my screen, but the computer's right here. Alabama in the house. Gypsy J. Gina, what's up? Tina. All right. How's everybody doing today on this Tuesday? Is everybody going up?
On Tuesday.
I gotta figure out what brushes I'm gonna use. I thought I had bought some squares. I know I have square ones. Stacy says, hi, it's 6:30 in the morning.
Morning.
You must be in Australia.
Good day.
Well, thank you, Jeremy Newman. Appreciate that. Hello, hello. We got the spinning wheel of death on your live. What is that? Where's the spinning wheel of death? Kenny, what's up, Kenny?
Kenny? Stranger.
Gypsy J, bleh, but it's almost done. Then sippy sippy. What do you got going on, Gypsy J? Next to your face of this. That's just a piece. That's a 40-inch round. So, I'm gonna be doing, you remember the black skull with the gold I just kind of did? One day, it's a couple months ago. Well, it went to a art show at Deep Elm Art Company here in Dallas. We always take a bunch of paintings pretty much every month to this place. And this one was sold and then almost got resold two or three times. Like, people wanted to buy it. So I thought I would make another one. I painted a teal round and I have another black one. I'd love to do a red one with gold. So that's what I'm gonna do today. So, with that said, hope everyone's having an awesome Tuesday. So check this out. So as you can see, I got this super bright. I have this camera set up to where it looks It should be upside down, but I flipped it. I hope you guys can see it right. So you guys can kind of see like it's overhead. Abstract Impressions. Patricia, Sheila, Gypsy J, so glad y'all are live to make a smile. You're welcome. Thank you. Thank you. You make us smile. Let me see here, 7:30 in the morning. Yawn.
Yeah.
Luck, all the luck on getting the job. Justine. So, give me 2 seconds. I'm gonna look for this brush, these two brushes that I want to use. I'm gonna have to get I've got a couple others. I'm gonna use these little ones. Might as well use these because these aren't very. I'm gonna do different. I plan on doing like more like square, sharp. I don't know. I guess it depends on how I feel. It always starts out. I always have to start with one, and then I kind of go from there. I can't plan it out. How do you clean? What do we clean that with? Alcohol and something else, right? Ooh, and we do have some here. Can't wait to use these thin ones to make some fun lines. You just have to really clean them really well. You'll never use them again. Got these on Amazon. These are like super cheap, so. I love using those little pinstripe ones, the little. I think all these are the same, so let's put these away. So I'm going to put some alcohol in one of these. And I'm going to get some, what is it? Paint thinner? Probably paint thinner will clean this stuff off, right? This gold, it's basically spray paint gold. I'm gonna get paint thinner. Turn it, then pop it. turn it out and pop it. There we go. Oh no, this is denatured alcohol. What am I doing? This is not the right stuff. I don't want to use this. Alright? How did I get that mixed up? Longish live today. Kinda. It really depends on how much I want to do to this. Mineral spirits might clean it off too, Jeff. I know. I wish I had mineral spirits. I don't think I have it. Paint thinner is just... It smells really bad. But I don't want to leave this brush. I don't want to leave any of these brushes in this gold paint, so... We'll see how it goes. Pretty sure that's what I used last time, so we can try to use all of them. So this is the paint thinner. Let's leave these over here. This is the alcohol. Always shake it up. Shake it up. Okay, I'll start working out. You have to stay live until I'm done. I see. I'm gonna have to get some more of this.
Your Yelp is on there, tell him to give it a rest.
I think I have this centered. I want to do a circle around it like I did last time, but I think I want to do more lettering. Ooh, this is not... it's going to take me a minute to do this, so... Y'all just kind of talk amongst yourself for a minute. I'm trying to get this centered. So I can make a circle on the outside. Uh-oh, I already put a mark on it. So how's everybody's Tuesday? Okay, awesome. I'm gonna try to center this. It shouldn't take too long. Hopefully this will work a little bit. I'm gonna put some tape on this so it'll stay. Cause I like to turn. Like, it's a lot easier if you get comfortable all the time while you're doing something like this. And not have to move around your work, but your work around you is a little easier. So like, let's say if I like pulling a line like this and I wanna, you know, I'm finished over here and I want to start here. I'd really like to just be able to do this and move it around in spots to where it's easier for me to get to it, because I feel comfortable with pulling this way than, you know, at a weird angle. So, yeah. Anita, maybe you just need to sleep in. Sometimes that's all you need, a little rest. Okay. All right, everybody can see. So, I think what I'm gonna do, I wanna start out with some more bigger lines. I don't mind that right now. I think that's what I wanted to do last time. Cause if you do the majority big stuff, like if you get like the shape, and then you can go in and fill in the little stuff with the little detail, that always looks nice. I don't want to, I'm not trying to fill in the whole, skull or the features. I just want some features to be a lot, I don't know if I like this brush though. It looks like it's a little janky. See that? It's like, it's like a little twisted here. I don't know if I want to use that. This is an old brush, but I love it. Hopefully that'll stay. You know what I'm gonna do, y'all? Because I don't want to. I'm gonna go ahead and do a little practicing first. That way I can kind of get that out of the way, right? All right, okay. Okay. Like, I don't know what kind of shapes I want to do yet. Like, because all of them are pretty, a lot of different stuff that you can do for a skull like this. You can make fat lines go skinny, follow a line. Very tribal, bro. See, this is fun. This gets you warmed up. Possibly could give you some ideas, Yeah, I wouldn't say a class. I would just say, this is how I do it. This is what's comfortable. This is, what works for me. And I pretty much taught myself, so I also thought about doing just letters on the inside of the skull. Just learn to use, I guess, to use what I have, because if you don't have the right stuff, you kind of adapt. There's a saying I like to say, you're only as good as your worst materials. it could be your best materials, which, you know, I guess you think it's the best, so you're just going to use them. You know, use it how it is. You know, you have a really skinny edge, fat edge. Use that, you know. If you're doing calligraphy, use it. My penmanship is horrible. Like, I have horrible penmanship. If I want to write something, it would take me forever to write, you know, something nice, because I have to, you know, it would, if I just regular write, it's terrible. I have terrible penmanship.
False.
Babe, it's true. How is it that, I mean, there's no way I have any kind of decent handwriting. Babe, that's because if I try, like if I'm doing something, like if I'm trying to make it look like something, but just normal writing, look at this. Okay, let's say I say, does anybody know? How horrible is that? Look at this. You can't even read it. Let's say, if I want to try to make it look like something, like, I misspelled that, didn't I? See, this is a different story. If I tried to make it look like something. Different story. Oh man, I forgot I put some. Ooh, paint thinner cleans that right off. That's good to know. You definitely don't want to leave this this gold on your brush. Look how cool that looks, y'all. The gold in the water, all metallic-y and whatnot. I forgot to put double stick tape on there. Look at this, y'all, and this is already dry. I think what I'm gonna do, if you can see this, it's so, you see how it's pretty dark here and then it lightens? I think I'm gonna do that and leave it and then take the airbrush and fade it, like, so it's looking like it might go under. Who knows? I don't know. We'll see. All right, so where do I wanna start? Ooh, I got gold on my hands. People wash their hands before they do artwork. Like, what's your routine right before you sit down and do some artwork?
Is that a question for you?
No.
That's a great question.
All right, so I think what I'm going to do, because that brush feels like it might be a little bit too big for these, like, I think I'm just gonna start with something, should I do around? Maybe this size. This is a nice size here. I'm gonna take this off, you guys. This is driving me crazy. That's a very soft brush. I don't know if I wanna use this. I think I wanna use one like this to go a little fat and then skinny. It's funny because all I need to do is just start and then I'll be fine. It drives me crazy whenever I don't know where to start. Maybe I'll just fill the teeth in for right now, just to get those filled in. This gold is so amazing. Should have drew in these teeth a little bit. But this is artwork, so it doesn't matter. So I'm just going to leave a gap around everything, around the, I'm not going to outline stuff per se, like I don't want it to be like it's meant to be outlined or anything. I've got to go look for some paint pens and check out. These Posca pens are awesome. Just don't get the kind with the, I believe it's Chinese writing. Posca pens come in English, just so you know. Is it backwards? Barely see these lines. Where's my picture at? I guess that would help if I had the picture. where to start? I guess I'll start out of the way of these teeth, let these teeth dry. Let's fill this part in. I'm gonna kind of go with the curvature, I guess you could say. That's going to take a minute to dry. Definitely have to wipe quite a bit off of your brush because it'll just settle in one place as you start to paint. Hello, Simon. Is that how to say that? Simon Unwin? Motorbike helmet? Yeah, that would look awesome. Need to get a better direction. discussion of where this is going. I'm liking this direction that I'm taking this. I feel like the other one had a little bit bigger paint strokes on it. paint is really smooth, like it goes on pretty easy. Thanks, Mike. Have a good day, bud. Thanks for stopping in. I feel like my camera keeps moving. last time I did this, I used the paint pen to do a lot of this detail, but this is so much fun to do this with the brush. And then I'll most likely come back in. I want to use that teal again. Plus this being teal, it looks super nice on here. Thanks, Clara. How are you? I just want to fill in some of the spaces. I don't want to use too much of a paint pen. Fan of that line I just pulled. I think the next one I want to do is I want to do more of like leaves. It's kind of what I wanted to do on this one, but I wasn't feeling that brush. I think the more you fill it in, the more it kind of takes shape. It's like the more you fill it in and the more you leave a negative space, it really gives it a good shape. As long as you leave negative space in there and not try to fill it all in. Looks good on this teal though, doesn't it? Like it's super fun. Funny because I can kind of tell where the paint is not as opaque looking at this, but when I look at the monitor, I can really tell. So that really helps with the monitor. That is an ugly line right there. These are not pretty lines. Thanks, Mary. Thanks, Linda. Jaw. funny because I'm trying to follow these lines and I'm not doing what I'm telling myself to do. And I don't know why. I'm like missing all these critical lines to make it look like a skull. And I don't know why I'm doing this. Back to my old way of thinking, and I'm not liking that. This looks funny at this angle, doesn't it, y'all? I feel like it's looking at it upside down. Alright, let's do some... Let's use this. I'm gonna use this round. I'm not sure how this is gonna turn out. I don't think I've used one of these on this before. We're gonna do some more filigree stuff, and then we're gonna hit that with the paint pen, probably the teal one. Also a really nice way to get a smooth line if you know where you're going with your line. so quiet, right? JJ.
And that looks really good.
Oh, nice.
Put it in your mouth.
That is different. What is that?
It's homemade orange chicken because I know you love it.
Mmm. Yeah, it's just different. Very orangey.
Yeah. I just went off the recipe. It's from fresh wheat orange juice. From me.
Everybody says hi. not a fan of all of that. I'm gonna have to do some thinner lines up there or something. Do I want to use this one or do I want to use them? Let's use the brighter. It looks like he's got like a crazy mohawk. Bye guys, off to drop my, for some reason I read dump. It's like, open the back door, like, boom, dump the kid off at Grand, at kindergarten. So I think I'm gonna do all inside stuff with this darker. So like if I go inside of here, I'm gonna do all that. I'm gonna do inside here, I'm gonna do one here. Inside the eyes and here. These colors are pretty good together. I like it. Kind of coming together a little bit more. I think I'm gonna fill this stuff in. This dark. You know what? I think I'm gonna go skinny gold with that. Give me a skinny gold paint pen. I'm just gonna kind of random fill it into the line so that these lines will be a little bit more defined. I don't know why I did what I did. I went way too close to these lines, and now you really can't see this definition here. See you, Gypsy. Thanks for coming in and hanging out. Well, thank you, Patricia Reed. I appreciate that. I'd love to put my 2 cents in where art things are involved. I think I should have done a little bit more practicing before I started this, to be honest with you. It's very random. I'm gonna put a little bit more of this darker teal. I feel like the other one had a little bit more better direction of what I was doing, a little bit more cohesive lines. I think on the black one, I'll probably do a little bit better. Cujo, come on, guy. You did it. You did it.
Good job.
Scared him all away. Cujo seems to think he needs to scare everybody in the house when the doorbell rings. Bigger gold. Yeah, he's definitely a watchdog.
So, as you can see at any base board.
Hi! Yeah. What's happening?
Smells like it's lunchtime.
Lunchtime, art time, every time. We're live, so no cussing, Bert. Gonna say hi to Bert, everyone. This is Bert.
Hello, hello.
This is the gentleman that makes our rounds now. Yeah. What's happening? Did you bring us? Oh my God! You guys, you don't understand. He just brought me a. Oh my God! That's it. This is it. Now, don't get too crazy, but these are the new coasters that I think we're gonna... These are just the first ones that he's shown me, which this is on... We're gonna do them on a little bit thicker, but this is exactly what I had in mind. That's crazy. That looks like a thumbprint. Like, and then a skull came out of it. How cool. Clara, I need, oh my gosh, need, yes please.
Looks
this.
Like
see, it's flat on this side, and then it's indented in this side. So I thought, wouldn't it be cool is to pour some resin in here and let it dry. Like, just do it up to the
yeah,
rim there.
You might want to do that.
Yeah. And that's why I want to do the thicker stuff. So you can, you know, carve it in a little bit deeper. But this is perfect.
And those are different. One's inverted and the other one's not. You need to tell me which one you like better.
Isn't, what do you mean, inverted and not?
Well, look at the
eyes.
I
see.
You can see in one case the eyes true, in the other case they don't.
Oh, yeah. Did you cut these on your...
So if you're going to pour into the recess, you probably want the one in your right hand.
These are yours, right? These aren't... Is this what I gave you?
Yeah.
Oh, I gave you just a blank. Yeah. I like this. I like more detail in there. Man, how many times did you go through that? Or did it like not? It looks like there's two or three of them on this one.
Mm-hmm.
This one looks, you understand? Like the outline. And there's one outline on this.
Yeah, there might be a little difference to the effort.
I like the look of this one on this side, but I like the idea of this.
Well, to me, this one almost looks like it's got a protruding nose and got glasses on.
Yeah.
When you look at it from the flat side. But I wondered if you might want to fill them. Because if you fill them, you know, that's not going to be the case. It'll,
yeah.
In fact, you could paint eyes into the recesses and then...
Shut up and take my money.
Cover it.
Is Jen on there? She'll be all over those.
Yeah. Well, we
so
need
what's
your
size?
Attention. This is awesome, yeah. Maybe if a little smaller to so just
yeah,
in case if you want to.
Off-center.
Yeah, that's nice.
They're both the same size. One's just centered correctly.
Where'd you get the skull at? Can I send you a skull? Or do you, this
well,
is the one you...
I don't really...
It's easier.
When I find out how you actually want them carved, and I got to see if I can find a skull that's a little more CNC friendly.
Yeah. This is a lot of detail.
To shake itself apart.
Right.
Pieces of that.
Yeah. If we could just do one that's just solid, like it doesn't have to have all this stuff in here, all I want is the detail of the teeth, the nose, and the eyes.
Well,
like,
the artifacts
this is just,
up in the other stuff are not necessarily controllable. Some of that is tools.
I see.
Tool marks. Some of it's the design, but
this one seems so much cleaner, but I love how this is indented. That's how I pictured it.
Well, decisions.
People are like, oh my god, I need 50 of those if possible. Somebody just wanted 50. Wow. Okay, thanks Bert for interrupting my live. Jeez. Appreciate it. I want one to polish out.
See, where's the tape measure?
It would take forever to get this cut out in a CNC, y'all. Right here. This is a little different than what I had in mind. As far as getting all this detail in here.
Did you tell her all about it? You did. I know you did.
Bowie's having a blast over there. Well, he does have a blue eye. I think I want to do some black stuff on this outside. I think it'll look good up against this dark teal. Think about that. I think I want to do that. Are they like just really winning? Like, you've been to a couple now, right? Like, is it like playoff season, or are they just...
No, it's like twice a week.
Oh, I see.
Not quite yet.
Are
you going to let me know?
Yeah. Of course. If anything, I'll just draw one out. Like, this is what I did today. Like, what if I just sent you one? Like this, and then it'll just leave that and carve all that out. I mean, I would probably make these a little bit thicker, but what if it was that simple?
You would like to have a side one?
No, well, that'll be in the future. I mean, I have them. I have all different kinds. I mean, I can do any. I'm not a fan of like a skull making a face. That has, you know, that. This is really like that. But yeah, this is exactly. I mean, that'll be later. I mean, or whatever. It's whatever. However you, it's easier for you.
Go online and look for STL skull models.
STL.
STL. Stereo lithograph.
STL. STL what? Skull model?
Skull models.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they... There's a jillion 3D skulls out there.
So,
awesome.
Find things you want and send it to me.
Cool. Do that.
And I'll work through and figure out which ones cooperate, and if some cooperate better than others.
Yeah.
Now, would you end up, you know, giving me sheets of this and I cut?
Of course.
Are those edges acceptable?
I mean, they're going to get resin on, so I don't think
it matters.
But it has to be a hexagon. I don't mind this shape, though. That is... Austin's here? Holy crap. I didn't know it was 4 o'clock. That's my son. All right. Well, awesome. Thanks, man. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Your left is orange chicken.
Thank you. Hopefully it works.
Bye.
Y'all fun at the game.
Oh, I know. I'm so excited. I know it.
That is fun. That's a little nerve-wracking, y'all, but it's fun. What's up? Yep, Austin's here, y'all. Say hi to Austin. Making it fun. I mean, you don't want it to leak any, right? You know?
No.
I want to make this sputter. Listen to him playing in there. Sup, Austin, sup, Austin, sup, Austin. Hi, Austin, sup, Austin. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? One, two, three. What's up? One, two, three. Sorry, it's a hottie overload. What's that? Can anybody name that movie? That is super fun, y'all. Cujo, what's up, Cujo? What you doing down there? Yeah, Claire, it's so, it's fun. Like, you just have to get that thing centered or else your circle will be off. Oh, you gotta, like, fish with it. Like, I mean, whip it back and forth to where he'll chase it. King Joe, where are you going? What are you going in the bedroom for?
Adventure?
No. I don't think so. I think then what I'm going to do with this, y'all, is in certain, like the bigger spots, I'm going to do actual gold leaf so it'll be real, so it'll really stick out. Yeah, I need to get him a little bit smoother skull. Maybe a little bit more rounded. Not so animated. I'm not a fan of the animation skull. I just like What's up, dog?
Up, dog.
Up, dog.
I want to be able to do that.
Be able to do what?
Be like, hey, you bringing me up, dog?
Mm-hmm.
What's up, dog? Nah. How are you doing?
How are you doing? You guys want to see what that looks like with some gold leaf on it? I think it'll look pretty cool.
Dad, would you rather be a baby goat or a madder baby?
You're dumb. I'm not even gonna get... Do you hear that tacky ass thing that he just said? Matter, baby. What's a matter, baby?
Oh.
Then what? She is blonde. What's the matter, baby?
Is that a rainbow?
I'll be doing better with some skull coasters. I think the next one I'm gonna make these lines a little bit more defined. I'm gonna follow it down like through the line, so that it's like, so I don't have to outline it, you know. But I think it's fun. I don't hate it. And that's a big part of. And I know I like.
Hey all.
I think I'm gonna put a purple circle on it. Cause I love circles. And I think a purple would look good on here. I just gotta think of where I want the circle. And how big. Look at this, y'all. What is up with that? All these little onions. That tastes like orange.
Huh?
Yes, please. Huh?
You talking to me?
Huh? Oh. Austin, she does exactly what you do.
Huh?
Louder.
Circle template.
Ooh, it'll be a good one. And in comes the sheety weather.
Over the ball pit, you might have
I said she weather. That's what I said. I didn't say the other word. Be fun right here. I'm just gonna put a circle like dots. I don't know why, but I always see these. In my work for some reason. I hope this like makes a nice smooth dot. I'll just do one, and if I don't like it, I'll just take it off. I wouldn't mind doing one of these, like, what's her name in Australia that does those dots? Karen? Her dot art is amazing. Like you do a dark one, a lighter, and a white. See, I like that because it's not really noticeable. Until you're like, oh my god, there's a circle right there. Oh my god. Also, you look like a fisherman from...
he was just fishing with Bowie.
The Deadliest Catch. Yeah, you could put Deadliest Catch from Bowie.
Bowie is the Deadliest Catch.
And I'll just go back over them, I think, with this so that they're a little bit more opaque. A little bit more noticeable. So Austin, you gonna do a painting? Why not? Your fans would love it. I think it's fun. Four minutes. Wow. The only thing that this does is it takes away from the curvature of his head. I wonder if I can just outline this. Now that definitely makes a difference. It looks good, huh, with that black outline. Kind of gives it a little bit more detail. It doesn't blend in with everything. It was fun, huh? Yeah.
You.
Austin's got his fishing pole. Ready to go fishing.
Oh, he's like fishing.
All right. I think I want to be done.
You're like, did you like fishing? If you aren't careful, he'll sneak up behind you and he'll just scratch. Just run off with it.
We'll sign this one right here. We'll sign it right here on this gold part.
What's that, Bobby? What's that? What's that?
Yeah. And she's Fanny. Now time to eat some orange chicken. So there you go. A little art today. A little different art. I know some people are like, I came here to watch resin. Just talk about resin. I've had people say that in comments. It's pretty funny.
Your art is still dead.
Yeah, so we do what we want, we do what we like, we do what we do a little bit of everything so that, you know, we're not just stale. We're not just doing the same old, same old, same old. We like to mix it up, we like to inspire, we like to be inspired from you guys especially. So yeah, thanks for showing up today. Ooh. I'll probably do some airbrush maybe Thursday or Friday, possibly Friday, because we're gonna go see Tool tomorrow night, so I'm not sure if I'll be up to airbrushing on Thursday. So yeah, we'll probably be early tomorrow too, so we'll see what happens. Be kind to one another. You never know what somebody's going through. Check out our website, We sell this board on our website. That's about it. Our cradle board. I think a lot of the other stuff is on our Amazon link. If you just go down to the description, find something, a link on Amazon, and as long as you're on our link, like if you go to our link and then you shop from that link, like go, we definitely, it helps us out. We get a little piece of whatever you buy. It goes all the way back into the channel. And so that really helps out a lot. Doing this every single day can take a toll, and it gets expensive. So you guys are awesome. Thank you so much for coming. We'll see you tomorrow, probably same time. Probably a little something different. Maybe some resin. Who knows? Maybe some, I don't know. It depends on what we feel like doing tomorrow. Maybe leave a comment below and let us know what you want us to do tomorrow. Okay? Thanks. Thank you, Clara. Thanks, JJ, for moderating. You guys are awesome. ArtistTellDeath.com. Go check us out. If you haven't subscribed, please do. Please like. Please leave a comment. If you dislike, please let us know why.
Turn on notifications.
Turn on notifications.
Ring the bell.
Ring the bell. Chop it up. You got this. Mike, we love you. Oh yeah, you guys have to check out the Artisan Summit, April 7th and 6th. I'm not sure. I feel bad. Clara knows. It's in April. It's in Vegas. We're speaking at it again. It's definitely worth it to go. It's information you definitely need. So check that out. You guys have an awesome day. Oh yeah, we got new pigments in from Just Resin too on the website, ArtistTellDeath.com. I think we got some stone coat in too.
We did.
We did get stone coat in, so.
Oh, they're discontinuing this and that. So what I have is literally the last in existence. It's not even on their website anymore.
Yeah, they're taking out stone coat countertops, this and that, which is their black base and their white base, and Erica bought the rest of it, so get it while it's hot, and we're not just saying that. So talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.
I said bye.
Austin?
I said bye.
That was the wrong one.